हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू आवर कोर्स मैकेनिक्स ऑफ सॉलिड। दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 5 एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट ट्रू स्ट्रेस एंड ट्रू स्ट्रेन। ओके, फ्रॉम द स्ट्रेस स्ट्रेन डायग्राम वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन लेक्चर नंबर 2, व्हाट इज ट्रू स्ट्रेस एंड ट्रू स्ट्रेन। ट्रू स्ट्रेस मीन्स, यू कैन सी दिस डेफिनेशन, the true stress is defined as the ratio of the internal resistance force to the cross section area at any instant, means with respect to time. If I say here, up to here there is no necking, after necking stress will be equal to load divided by actual area, load डिवाइड बाई एक्चुअल एरिया। ओके, एट दैट पर्टिकुलर टाइम लोड डिवाइड बाई एक्चुअल आर एरिया। हियर आफ्टर नेकिंग क्रॉस सेक्शन एरिया इज डिक्रीजिंग ड्यूरिंग टेंसाइल टेस्ट आफ्टर अल्टीमेट स्ट्रेंथ ड्यूरिंग नेकिंग एक्चुअल एरिया इज डिक्रीजिंग ड्यू टू दैट टाइम स्ट्रेस विल बी आल्सो इंक्रीज ट्रू स्ट्रेस विल बी इंक्रीज बट इन इंजीनियरिंग स्ट्रेस दैट विल बी गो डाउन बिकॉज लोड इज डिक्रीजिंग एट दैट टाइम एरिया आल्सो डिक्रीजिंग ड्यू टू दैट वी आर गेटिंग दिस टाइप ट्रू स्ट्रेस कर्व बट ट्रू ओके ट्रू स्ट्रेस इज डिफाइंड एज internal resistance force to the cross section area at any instant load divided by instantaneous area and how we can find out sigma t true stress equal to sigma 1 plus mu here this mu is engineering strain okay and this is true stress and here this is engineering This is engineering strain. Okay. Engineering strain means whatever we are calculating, load divided by area. Area means initial area without any reduction in area. That area we are using here. It's already written here. Sigma and mu are engineering stress and strain. Okay. And true strain, how we can find out? To find out true strain, change in length. divide by length and this length is with respect to time this length is changing with respect to time why because length is increasing if you are applying tensile load compressive load length is decreasing that increase or decrease length we should take here if you do integration of this one l0 to l because final length is l initial length is L0 to L integration of del L divided by L you will get log L by L0 this simple integration okay from that we can find out this formula how we got this one if you want to write this one this will be L0 plus del L okay divided by L0 From that you can L 1 plus dl by l same thing here del l by l is this one engineering strain 1 is 1 here so log 1 plus mu engineering true strain equal to log 1 plus engineering strain this can be also write as in this way from here this came like this how it came if I say volume of the specimen is assumed to be constant during deformation during applying load if you assume there is no reduction or increase in volume is constant that time a0 l0 equal to al okay from that you can find out l by l0 equal to here L by L0, so A0 by A. From that we got this one, okay. And how we got this one? For a circular section, what is area? Area equal to pi d square by 4. So A0 by A equal to, simply you can say pi du square by 4, then pi d square by 4. So all this will be cancelled. Okay, we'll get d0 by d square. Same thing here, you can write this one equal to ln d0 by d square. So this two will come here. Okay, this is formula how we can calculate true stress and true strain. Okay, now let's go to solve some numerical problem. We will solve two different example. First example, if there is no necking, okay, no necking formation, only elongation, no necking, okay. If there is no change in volume, we will solve one problem. In the ten, read the question, this one concern. In the tension test, a rod shown initially it was A0 equal to initial area equal to 50 mm square, initial length is 100 mm. After the application of load, area, new area equal to 40 mm square and L length is 125. Determine the true strain using change in both length and area. We need to find out true strain. Okay, how we can find out? First of all, we need to check, is there any neck formation, is there any change in volume. We need to check that one. So how we can check? A0 L0 equal to AL. If this is correct, we can use any formula out of this. Out of this, any formula we can use if that is correct. Okay, so here 50 into 100, because initial area 50 into 100, final area 40 into final length 125, both are equal. Okay, so no neck formation is there, no change in volume. Therefore, true strain will be, any formula we can use, true strain mu t equal to ln 125 by 100. What is this one? This one ln L by L0. Okay. And second one ln A0 by A. From both formula we get the same answer. Okay, so true strain equal to 0.223. Let's solve another one example. Elongation with neck formation means with change in volume, with volume change. Read the question. A ductile material is tested such and neck occur, then the final gauge length is L, this is final length 140 mm, final minimum cross section area, final area given us. So the rod show initial area given us 50 mm square, initial length given us 100 mm. Okay, determine the true strain using change in both length and area. Using both formula we need to find out true strain. Okay, so first of all we should check if this is correct or wrong. Okay, if this is true, then we can use any formula. So we'll check that one. A0 L0 equal to 50 into 100 equal to 5000 mm cube. AL, this final area into final length, equal to 35, this one 35 into 140. So we are getting 4200 mm³. So both are not equal. A0 L0 is greater than AL. Means there is neck formation and chain volume. In that condition, therefore true strain will be, we should use this formula, okay? We should use area formula instead of length formula. If we use area formula ln A0 by A, ln 50 divided by 35, we are getting 0.357. But not, we should not use this one. If you use this one, you will get something different. Okay. Ln L by L0. This is ln L by L0. Okay. L by L0. From that we got this one 0.336. It is wrong. Actually, we should not use this one. If there is any neck formation, if there is chain volume, we should always use area instead of length. After necking, gauge length give error, but area and diameter can be used for the calculation of true strain at fracture and before fracture also. Okay. Thank you. We solved two different problems. First one without necking, without chain volume. Second one with chain volume. We solved two different problems. If there is chain volume, that time we should use formula of area. Okay, formula of area we should use. Either you can use area or diameter. Area or diameter if there is neck formation. Okay, thank you.